Welcome back to the Urban Penguins channel. My name is Andrew Mallett, and today we're going to continue with our Learning Linux series with Lesson 12, looking at the Network Time Protocol, NTP. So managing time on your Linux devices is very important. Pretty much everything in Linux and many operating systems will require accurate time. What is the point of having certificate services if we can't check the accurate time? What is the point of logging if we can't accurately detect when that logging was made? So we're going to move into our configuration and see that we can configure it in YAST, although it may be easier and more sensible to configure from the command line. So if we open up our YAST utility and put in our root password and try and get the password correct, and then in the search dialog box we can find the NTP module just by typing NTP, and we see the NTP configuration. So single click in YAST to open this up, and like most of the YAST utilities, we can start the service now and we can start it on boot. So this makes it very simple. Of course, we can then tell it to start now and make our configuration. By default, it will synchronize with the local clock, but we would normally add in additional servers or peers. So we can then add in a server and go next and put in the server's address. We can, of course, type in the address, or from the dialog box, we can actually select a list of public NTP servers. So again, this makes it very simple. We don't have to do a lot of research of which external servers to synchronize with. It does have an option in here for iBurst. We'll talk more about the iBurst option later, but it's probably not a good option to use on public servers. So we can make our configuration through YAST, but as I say, it doesn't really expose the whole of the configuration. So if we go through and look at it from the command prompt, so if I open up my command prompt, give myself a little bit of extra font so it's easier to see. And then we'll just use SU to gain some additional privileges. So SU for switch user, SU minus is then switching to the root user and reading the login scripts for that user. I'm going to edit the ntp.conf in the etc directory. Again, like many of these files, they're well documented, and we probably would do well to copy this file and then clear out some of the comments. For ease, I'm just going to delete some of these comments now so we're more able to see the configuration. So now, if we like, with the settings that are made and we're configuring to synchronize as we saw before from YAST with the local clock. Because the local clock itself is just a chip on the motherboard, it's not actually a time service that we're synchronizing, then we have to fudge the entry. And we say that the local clock then is fudged as a Stratum 10 server. So if I get time from a Stratum 10 server, I would then become a Stratum 11 server. So fudge is a colloquial term in English, saying that we're really manipulating an entry. As we move down, we can see the drift file. The drift file is very important. So if we are synchronizing with the server, but we lose communication for a while, we can see our average drift over a period of time and then maintain the accuracy with our reference server. Of course, the log file is where we log to, and then the key material is if we want to use security. So of course I want to add in my own server or servers. I'm adding in an internal server, so 192.168.0.8. For this I'm quite happy to use the iBurst option. The iBurst option says look, synchronize very quickly. If I had lots of servers that powered on all at the same time, I wouldn't want to use iBurst because it would flood my NTP server. Whereas if I only have a few servers that don't all turn on at the same time, iBurst gives us quick synchronization. if I'm going to have multiple servers, my internal server probably should be the server of choice, so I can add another option of prefer in. With the prefer option, kind of as it says on the tin, this becomes the preferred server. And then I'm adding in my third server. The third server will just go to uk.pool.ntp.org. So a DNS alias that contains a group of servers, a DNS round robin. So again, load balances across a range of servers, and very easy to remember. So once I'm ready with this, I would save my changes. And with those saves made, we start the service. So rcntp, or remember, if this was standard Linux, we probably just would use service ntp start, and we can see that straight away we synchronize with the preferred server. We look at some of the tools that we can use then to manage this, are ntpq-p, and we can see the asterisk showing that we've already set the 192 server up as our preferred server for synchronizing. And if we run the ntp trace, we can see now that the local host is stratum 5, because it is getting its time from 192.168.0.8, which is a stratum 4 server. And it's quite normal that we time out when we're connecting to public servers, but we would know that server 95.172 would have to be a stratum 3 server. Again, we can see in the output of ntpq where our clocks are, so the local clock, the 192, where it gets its time from, and then the entry that I put in for UK pool and where it would get its time from. So we have a little bit of information, and we see their stratum numbers. So stratum 10 for the local clock, stratum 4, which we know because we can see it also with ntp trace, and then the stratum 2 for the ntp name server, UK pool dot. We can see when they're polling. So to begin with, they poll every 64 seconds, and the when just tells me where we are in that cycle. The reach number would just increment each time we run through and reach to 64. You will find the poll interval of 64 seconds increases over a period of time. If we want to look at this in a little bit more detail, we can watch it, which will then go through and show me every 2 seconds the output of ntpq-p. And we can see then with our proper servers that we're incrementing until we reach 64 seconds. The reach value is a little bit weird. It counts in octets, I think, from 1, 3, 7. So it's a little bit weird the way they count there. The delay values, so we can see here the values for delay, offset and jitter are all in milliseconds, so this is the round trip delay. The offset is the adjustment between the system clock and the reference clock, and the jitter is then the difference between several readings from the local clock and the system clock. Always large to begin with, because initially it makes an adjustment, but when we look at that saying large, 391 is only 391 milliseconds. We can see this builds up over a period of time. And the last thing, of course, is to make sure the service starts each time the service starts. So I just do my check config -a ntp.